Baton Rouge, Louisiana at Tiger Stadium. These fans are anxious to see this game get started. It's time for football, and the fans are anxious to get this one started as we give you what should be an exciting game between the Tennessee Volunteers and the LSU Tigers. Hi, everybody, and welcome to another edition of EA Sports NCAA Football. I'm Brad Nessler, joined here by Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit. Neither team seems to have an advantage in this game, so this ought to be a tight game. Lee?
You know what? Tennessee has prepared all week offensively for this ball game. Their offense is ready to roll. But you know what? It's not their offense they need to worry about. It's their defense. Kirk, I think this defense is really going to struggle today against the pass, and they'll lose this one in a shootout.
Coach, I think this one's too close to call. Tennessee really likes their chances in this one, especially if it's a high-scoring shootout. Why, you ask? It's because of their big-time playmaking wide receiver. If I were their coach, I would make sure this guy touches the ball as much as possible. Kick returns, punt returns, everything. Just get him his touches. I think it's going to be a close game, Brad, but in the end, I think that the talented wide receiver will have made just enough big plays for his team to win.
We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. Number 19 kicks it off. Number 25 fields it in the end zone. Ball on the 21. LSU goes with the ace set here. He's looking for his man. Second and 10. Tennessee lines up defensively in a 4-3. At the 22. The defense just swarmed over him on that.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Ball on the 22-yard line. Third and 8. Tennessee brings in their nickel package. Drops back. He throws it, and it's caught. Number 30 brings him down at the 24. He didn't get the first down.
Hey, fantastic job by the defense there by not allowing to get any yards after the catch.
It's fourth down and 6. Number 26, the return man. Number 80 gets it off. Number 26 fields it at the 39. It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. LSU comes out in a 3-4. Number 7, back to throw. He gives a pump fake. He lets it go. It falls incomplete. It's second down and 10 to go. They use four linebackers. Back to pass. He unloads it. Incomplete pass. Ball on their own 38. LSU brings in their nickel package. Back to pass. Rifles this one out to the left. Complete. Number 5 with a takedown at the 36-yard line. And they convert the third down with a long pass play.
You're right, Brad, and that was a long pass play. As a coach, you got to appreciate it when your players come out and perform like these kids are doing right now.
Ball on the 36-yard line. The Tigers come out into 34 defense. Drops back to pass. He's looking for his man. And it's incomplete. There was a lot of pressure on the quarterback there.
Yeah, he had to get rid of him in a hurry, and that's why his pass was off.
Second and 10, ball on the 36. LSU comes out in a 4-3. And he's taken down at the 33. 3 yards there on the play. Ball on the 33. Number 34 lines up in a deep back, eye formation. Steps back to pass. He unloads it. And he dropped it. It's fourth down and 6 yards to go. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. The kick is up. And it's good. Tennessee to kick this one off. He kicks it. Number 25 fields it at the 1. It's first and 10, ball on their own 32. LSU sets up in the eye. He drives it. Rifles it over the middle. Number 25 hangs on to it. How about your assessment of that long play, Kirk?
Well, Brad, not only a big pass play, but anytime you can stretch a defense on first or second down like this, you're going to open up your running game.
First and 10, ball on the 34-yard line. Going with the shotgun here. He drops back. Fires across the middle. He's got the first. It's first and 10. Tennessee lines up defensively in a 4-3. He lets it go, and it's caught. Number 30 brings him down at
the 11.
How about that pass, Kurt?
You know, guys, one of the things often overlooked in college football is the relationship between a quarterback and his receiver. Here, you can see that these two are definitely on the same page.
Ball on the 11. Four-man front by the defense. He spins around, brought down at the 8-yard line. He picked up the first down on that one.
Yeah, I like the way they ran the ball on that play. There's more where that came from, believe me.
They come out in a goal line set. They're bringing it. Touchdown, Tigers! And that was an impressive run for the score.
Forget about it. They didn't have a chance of stopping that kid there.
That one's worth another look. Point. LSU is ready to kick it away. Here's the kick. Number 26 fields it at the 3. He jukes. First and 10. Ball on their own 20. Tennessee comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Number 7 steps back to pass. And they couldn't hook up on that one. What happened on that one, Kurt?
Well, I think he's trying a little bit too hard to make that perfect throw. Just step back, fire the football. Don't think so much about it.
Second and 10. Tennessee sets up in the eye, drops back. He's looking for his man, number 80, has it. And they make the stop at the 38. What a catch, and that's going to give him a first down.
Well, that's a big play for the offense, but I think the defense needs to play a little bit tighter in the secondary.
Ball on the 38-yard line. Number 34 is a deep back as they line up in the eye. Number 96 with a takedown at the 44-yard line. Well, Coach, he picked up a few yards on that one.
Brad, tough running by this kid.
After a quarter of play, our score is LSU 7, Tennessee 3. We are ready to start quarter number 2. Second and 4 coming up here. Ball on the 44-yard line. Tennessee goes with the ace set here. Back to pass. He throws it. Number 34 with a catch. Number 28 brings him down at the 29. And he hauled that one in for a first down.
Well, that's a big-time play. Did an excellent job there of getting separation from the defender, and he's able to pull down that pass for quite a few yards.
It's first and 10. Drop back pass. He passes it. First down. Number 5 with a takedown at the 12-yard line. He got up in the air and made the catch.
Well, that's all about timing, too, because if he jumped too early, he wouldn't have been able to catch that ball.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 12. They line up in an eye. Number 7 steps back to pass. He's on the run. He unloads it. It falls incomplete. It looks like he overthrew him on that one.
I'll tell you, I think the quarterback got rid of that one too quickly, Kirk.
Coach, you're right. They need to work on their timing a little bit more.
Ball on the 12-yard line. The Volunteers line up in an I formation. Options out. He laterals the ball. It's scooped up. They'll bring him down at the 12. And so they'll turn the ball over on the fumble.
Yeah, the ball carrier just didn't do a good job of protecting the ball. This defense took advantage of it.
Ball on the 12. It's first and 10. Tennessee comes out in the 3-4. Number 21 brings him down at the 4-yard line. 8 yards back on the play. Second and long. 4-3 defense. Number 6, back to pass, lets it go. Number 24 makes the catch, a 5-yard gain. Ball on the 9-yard line. The Tigers come out in the shotgun. He's looking for his man. Kirby just let that one get away from him.
Yeah, and you can see he wants that one back. That's a throw this guy can make in his sleep.
Ball on their own 9. Number 26, back to return it. He gets it off. Number 26 takes it at the 49. Ball right around midfield. The Tigers line up in a nickelback. Makes a handoff. Fires a bullet over the middle. He's got the first. Number 21 with a takedown at the 4. We knew these receivers were fast and athletic, and they are not disappointing us.
I think these guys are the difference makers in the game. I'd expect to see the deep routes to keep coming and coming at this defense.
Crowding that line of scrimmage. And he's in there. Touchdown. And so they're able to finally get this one in the end zone on the ground.
You know what? We always talk about the running backs, but I got to give some credit to the offensive line there. They made that play happen. PAT.
Tennessee to kick. Number 19 kicks it off. Number 25 fields it in the end zone. Ball on their own 21. It's first and 10. The Tigers line up in an I formation. He spins. Number 9 brings him down at the 20. Touchdown, Volunteers! And that is not what they had in mind.
It was simply a bad play. Turnovers are bad on their own, but when you add to the fact that it resulted in points for the opposition, that will kill you every time.
And he tacks on the extra point. Tennessee is ready to kick it away. He kicks it. Number 25 fields it in the end zone. First and 10, ball on their own 21. The Volunteers line up in a 4-3. Spin move. Tackle at the 21. Couldn't get anything out of that. Second and 9 coming up here. Ball on the 21-yard line. Going with the shotgun here. He drops back. Incomplete pass. Now it's 3rd and 9 coming up. Ball on their own 21. Tennessee brings in their nickel package. Number 6 drops back. Throws it out there, and they couldn't hook up on that one. And that one was a little off target.
Yeah, he had a little too much mustard on that one, Brad. He needs a little bit more touch in those passes and let the receivers go get it.
It's 4th down, 9 yards to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. Number 26, back deep to return. Number 80 gets it off. Number 26 fields it at the 34, and they make the stop at the 46-yard line. Came away with a nice return there, Lee Corso.
Whoa, Nelly. That was almost a big one, my friend.
First and 10, ball on the 46. Tennessee comes out of the shotgun. Back to pass. He lets it go. Number 80 hangs on to it. About 6 yards on the play. Ball right around midfield. Nickel defense. Number 7 drops back to pass. Rifles it right side, and it's incomplete. Ball on the 48. We've got third and three here. The Tigers come out in a 34 defense. It's a blitz. Number 56 with a takedown at the 43. That's 4 yards on the play. It's first and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Tennessee comes out with an I formation. This one thrown deep over the middle. Incomplete pass. Well, they try to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. He needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
Ball on the 43-yard line. Tennessee lines up in a shotgun set. Back to pass. Gives a little pump fake. He passes it. It falls incomplete. He just couldn't get to that one.
Well, he looked to be a little excited back there in the pocket. May have rushed things a little bit. Needs to be a little bit more patient. Step up, make the throw.
Ball on the 43. The Volunteers come out in the shotgun. Drops the throw. Fires a bullet over the middle. Complete. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. Wow, how about that third down conversion?
Boy, what a play here, guys. I'm really impressed with the poise of this young quarterback. He was very cool and collected out there on that third and long play.
The offense takes a timeout.
First and 10, ball on the 32. The Volunteers go with the I formation. Can't wrap him up. Number 54 brings him down at the 29.
Timeout called by the offense.
Eighth play of this drive coming up. LSU lines up defensively in a 4-3. He jukes him. Tackle at the 23. So he got a few yards on that carry.
You know what, guys? If you can continue to pick up small chunks of yards like that, you can really start to wear a defense down.
Ball in the 23. Third down and short. They're crowding the line. He drops back, throws it out there, and it's caught. Number 33 with a takedown at the 16. 6 yard pickup. Ball on the 16.
The offense takes a timeout.
We'll see what they can do in the red zone. Three-man front defensively. The kick is up. And it's good. Tennessee to kick this one off. Number 31 and number 0 back ready to return. Here's the kick. Number 25 fields it in the end zone. Ball on their own 15. Tennessee going with a three-man front. They'll bring him down at the 24. Here's another look at that fantastic run. And that'll do it for the first half of play. Our halftime score, Tennessee 20, LSU 7. LSU got the ball to start the game, so they'll be kicking off to start the second half. Number 40 kicks it off. Number 80 fields it in the end zone. First and 10, ball on their own 21. Number 34, lines up as a single back, drops back to pass. And they couldn't hook up on that one. So it's second and 10, ball on the 21. Number 34 is the deep back as they line up in the eye. He drops back. He throws it. Complete. Number 33 brings him down at the 39. And he threw that ball in there nicely. Did you see that, Coach?
Yes, I did, Brad. And that was a good pass and a very good game.
Ball on their own 39. It's first and 10. Tennessee sets up in the eye. Drops back to pass. Let's it go. Number 45 with a takedown at the 40-yard line. He picks up a yard on the play. Ball on the 40. It's second down and 8 to go. Number 7 is back in the gun. Number 28 brings him down at the 45. And he carried that one for a few yards.
You know, when you have a guy like that who can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure keeps some pressure off the passing game.
Ball on the 45-yard line. It's third down and 4 to go. The Tigers bring in their dime package. He drops back. And it's caught, knocked out of bounds at the 49-yard line. 7-yard play. Ball right around midfield. Tennessee comes out with an I formation. Back to throw. Lets it fly. Number 15 drops it. I think the pressure forced him to get rid of the ball there, guys.
Yeah, great job here by the defense. Getting a good surge up front, getting right into the quarterback's face.
Ball on the 49-yard line. Going with the shotgun here. To throw. Chucks it deep down the right side. And it falls incomplete. Well, he was under some heavy pressure there.
Well, I agree there was a lot of pressure, but I think he can hold on to the ball just a little bit longer and deliver it with some confidence.
Third and 10, ball on the 49-yard line. They line up in an eye. Back to pass. He unloads it. And that one's fallen incomplete. It's fourth down and 10 yards to go. Number 31 waiting the return. Punts the ball away. Oh, that was a beautiful punt.
Whoa, you can see that again. That's very good accuracy to be able to pin him back deep like that. That was a good one.
First and 10. Tennessee brings in their nickel package. Number 6 steps back to pass. He's looking for his man. Complete. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Ball on their own 7. It's second down and 9 to go. Four-man put by the defense. Number 28 with a takedown at the 12-yard line. And that was a nice job of running.
You know what, Brad? If they can utilize a balanced offense, mix up the run with the pass, they should be able to get more of these 5 to 6 yard runs.
Ball on the 12. It's third down and 5 to go. The Tigers line up in an I formation. Number 6 drops back. Throws it out there. Number 24 has it. Number 28 brings him down at the 19. 7 yards there. First and 10, ball on the 19. The Tigers come out in the ace formation. Number 37 with a takedown at the 26-yard line. That's a nice 6-yard gain. Second and 3 coming up. Number 22 alone in the backfield. Here comes the defense. Number 9 brings him down for a loss. Drop back 4 yards on that one. Third and 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 21. Tennessee lines up in a dime defense here. Number 6 steps back to pass. He throws it. And it's caught. Jets it back. And he shoved out of bounds at the 33. And they get the first down. That is unbelievable.
Wow, Kirk, this quarterback's showing some big-time nerves out there. Third and long, it's just like first and 10 to this guy.
Yeah, you're right. A lot of poise from this young man.
Ball on their own 33. Tennessee comes out defensively with 6 defensive backs. Drops back to pass. Complete. Brought down at the 29. 3-yard loss there. This is the 8th play of this drive. The Tigers come out in the ace formation. Brings him down at the 31-yard line. 1 yard on the play. This is the 9th play of this drive. LSU comes out in the shotgun. Number 6 drops back. He lets it go. Number 16 tips it away. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
Ball on the 31-yard line. Number 26, the return man. He punts it. Number 26 takes it at the 33. Ball on their own 33. It's first and 10. The Volunteers come out in the shotgun. Drop back to pass. He's looking for his man. Incomplete. It looks like he overthrew him on that one.
I'll tell you, I think the quarterback got rid of that one too quickly, Kirk.
Well, Coach, you're right. They need to work on their timing a little bit more.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 33. Tennessee comes out with an I formation. Number 7 drops to throw. Now he's scrambling. He fires right. Number 96 with a catch. They'll bring him down past the 49. That was a nice leaping catch.
You know, those passes can be dangerous, too, because the receiver makes himself vulnerable jumping in the air like that.
Bring this quarter to an end. Folks, we played three, and our score is Tennessee 20, LSU 7, and we're ready to start quarter number 4. Ball right around midfield. Three-man front defensively. Back to pass. He guns it to the right. Number 4 drops the ball, and an outstanding play defensively.
Yeah, he timed it perfectly and managed to get a hand in there to deflect the ball away.
Ball on the 49-yard line, so it's second and 10. The Volunteers come out in the 8th formation. Number 7 drops back to pass. Swatted away. He was able to just knock that one away.
Yeah, great play here by the defensive back, locating the ball and going up to bat it away.
This is the 5th play of this drive. The Volunteers come to the line with their jumbo package. Number 7 with a takedown at the 47-yard line. They'll get 2 on that one. Ball on the 47. Fourth down now at 7 yards to go. Number 31 back to return it. He punts it. Ball on the 21-yard line. The Tigers come out in the shotgun. Back to pass. He throws it. Number 16 knocks it away. And they do a good job at swatting that one away.
You're right, Brad. Excellent awareness by the defender to know where the football is and get his hand on it.
Second and 10. Tennessee brings in their nickel package. Number 6 drops to throw. He passes it, and it's caught. And they make the stop at the 28. That's a 7-yard gain. Ball on the 28-yard line. Third and 2. Eye formation here. Defense is blitzing. Throws it out there. Number 25 makes the catch. And down he goes at the 40. And they convert the third down with a long pass play.
You're right, Brad, and that was a long pass play. As a coach, you got to appreciate it when your players come out and perform like these kids are doing right now.
Ball on the 40. The Tigers go with the I formation. Number 6 steps back to pass. Number 3 hangs on to it. Ball on the 32. Defense lines up in a 4-3. He lets it go. Number 25 drops it. This is the 6th play of this drive. Tennessee lines up in a dime defense here. Number 6, back to throw. He unloads it. First down, and he's taken down at the 26. A pickup of 5. Ball on the 26. LSU lines up for the ace set. He throws it. Complete. And he's tackled at the 22-yard line. Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Second down and 5. Ball on the 22-yard line. The Volunteers bring in the nickel package. It falls incomplete. Kirky just let that one get away from it.
Yeah, and you can see he wants that one back. That's a throw this guy can make in his sleep.
Third and 5 coming up. Ball on the 22. Number 6 lines up in the shotgun. Back to throw. He lets it go. Number 83 has it. Tackle at the 21. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Ball on the 21. LSU comes out with an I formation. And it falls incomplete. They hold on fourth down.
Now that's how you get a team motivated. I wouldn't be surprised to see their offense take the field with an explosive power attack.
It's first and 10. They line up in an eye. Defense is blitzing. He spins, and he's tackled at the 25-yard line.
Defense takes a timeout.
Second and 6, ball on the 25. The Tigers come out in a 34 defense. He spins around. Number 45 brings him down at the 29.
The defense takes a timeout.
Third and 2. Ball on the 29-yard line. 4-3 defense. Defense is blitzing. A little shake and bake move. He's got the first tackle at the 37-yard line. Big, big gain on that one.
Yeah, that's a big first down, too. Just keep moving those sticks,
and wear down that defense.
Ball on the 37. They line up in an eye. Tries to juke. Number 56 with a takedown at the 42-yard line.
The defense takes a timeout.
This is the fifth play of this drive. The Volunteers line up in an I formation. He jukes it. Missed tackle. And down he goes at the 46. Nice pickup on that one.
Boy, it always helps when you're running behind a bunch of big daddies like these guys.
Let's take another look at that run. Ball on the 46. They use four linebackers. Ball right around midfield. The Tigers line up with a three-man front. The final gun, and this game is history. Any final thoughts on this one, Coach?
I don't know about you guys, but I was pretty darn impressed with this bunch of kids. Tennessee faced a pretty good opponent in this one, but they just marched right through them. I'm telling you, these guys are for real.
Folks, thanks for spending your time with us in another game of NCAA Football 2002. We look forward to bringing you more great college football action in the future. Again, our final score, Tennessee 20, LSU 7. From all of us here at EA Sports, we hope to see you again soon. Goodbye, everybody.